Well, I suppose it'd have to come sooner or later. But I'm surprised at you, Trixie. I thought you and me were mates.
You got no mates, Mackenzie. You're a bloody maniac.
Maybe if you're in my shoes, you'd do the same.
Oh, I can't. Oh. Ah!
So you think the women beat her up?
Of course they did. I know I certainly didn't. But it's very strange that whenever there's any talk of dirty work among the staff, my name always seems to crop up.
Mackenzie hasn't accused you of anything.
Oh, give her time. That one is only just getting started. Before she's through, she'll be more trouble than Bea Smith ever was.
It was Nola, wasn't it? She bashed you.
Forget it, will you? Don't stir anything up, please.
But I gotta tell Bea.
No, Faye, please. Just wait till tomorrow after I'm out of here.
You want a fag?
What are you trying to do? Buy yourself back into favour?
No. Why should I?
Yeah. Why should you?
Listen, Nola, I didn't do nothing. They wanted me to, but I wouldn't be in it.
No. But you were the cockatoo. I know everyone who was involved, from the one who kept knit to the one who organised it all. I'm surprised at that Smith, though. I didn't think she was the type to get other people to do a dirty work for her.
It wasn't Bea's idea.
Oh, pull the other one. She goes around here telling everyone that nothing happens unless she says so. Well, I don't take kindly to being thumped about. That's something the great Bea Smith has to learn. The hard way.
You gotta be kidding. Bea's top dog.
Big deal.
No, I mean, she stayed that way for years because she just thumps anybody who crosses her. Hell, if you wanted to be top dog,
you... Nobody's taking over. I couldn't be bothered wet nursing you lot. All I want to do is give her a facial. Nobody pushes me around. She's got you lot beaten from the start. You're scared stiff of her.
Well, it's not just her. She's got mates.
Good. Then I'll get mates too. What do you reckon, Faye? Do you want to be my mate?
Oh, yes, sure, Nola. Sure I do. But I wouldn't be any good to you in a fight. I'm too little.
But you got big ears, that's all I want. Just to know what they're up to.
Yeah, but nobody'd tell me nothing if they thought we was mates.
But they won't know we're mates.
Ah!
When they see your face in the morning, they'll really think that I've got it in for you, won't they?
Oh!
Won't they?
Yeah. Well, I was only telling you about this chap in the magazine, and he reckons that if everybody stopped swearing, they'd improve their vocabulary by 25%.
Yeah? And you reckon you're going to give up swearing, eh? Bet you can't.
Of course I bloody could.
There you go already. Well, do you want to bet or not?
Oh, half a mile. I'll have to think about that. Oh, I've been doing it for 73 years. What's in it for me if I win?
Don't know. How about five fags?
Five fags? I'd do a tap dance on the table for that.
Can't wait to see this.
Just a minute, you two. Bit sloppy with the makeup this morning, Quinn. It's all over your face.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. I bashed it against a wall. I must have had a nightmare.
Is that true, Mackenzie?
Well, how would I know? I was too busy sleeping.
Oh, of course you were. I know. Get going.
Day off. Oh, hectic. Come back here for a rest if you really must know.
Well, I wouldn't count on that.
Apparently things got a bit hectic here yesterday. Had to let Mackenzie out of solitary.
You're joking, why?
Oh, I didn't hear the full story, but apparently her lawyer got very heavy with Mrs. Davidson. But just keep an eye on her, will you? She's already had one bashing. Want a coffee?
No, thanks. Well, I'm not surprised. If only that new isolation block was finished. Her lawyer couldn't object to that. After all, it is the best way to keeping her protected from the other women.
Yeah. Well, that's the trouble. We're not sure it was the women who bashed her. She hinted it was an officer.
And did she hint who this mysterious officer was?
No, and I don't think we should jump to any...
Oh, for God's sake, Colleen. We both know she meant Joan, so why not say it?
Because, as usual, there's no proof. Just her uncanny knack of coming out on top, and I'm not going to put my job on the line for her again.
Proof, eh? Well, if that's all we need...
How's Mrs. Morris this morning?
Hey, Lizzie. Gonna be the easiest 5 fags I ever got.
Yeah. It's me who's getting them, not you.
Only if you win. If you lose, you gotta pay me.
In that case, we'll double the bet. 10 fags. Only you gotta give up swearing, too.
Me give up swearing? Don't be a pain in the bum.
10 fags. If I can make the effort, so can you.
You wanna tell me about it?
What?
Come on, you know what, and don't tell me you ran into a door.
Jeez, but you've got to do something about her.
Mackenzie?
Yeah, she's a flaming rat bag. I mean, I expected something after what happened yesterday, but she just went berserk.
Are you all right?
Yeah. I don't know about Trixie, but...
What happened to her?
Oh, well, you know when you saw me coming out of the cell yesterday? Oh, jeez, B, you should have seen her. Poor kid was a right mess after Mackenzie finished with her.
Hey! Has anyone seen Trixie this morning?
No, she must have got out early, the lucky thing.
Oh, well, at least she's safe.
Yeah, but what about the rest of us? Nola reckons she's going to get everybody who bashed her, and she's after you most of all.
Is that right? We'll see about that.
Do to get it looking like that?
Churn it around the concrete mixer for a couple of days. What else? No wonder Lizzie isn't here. Someone must have tipped her off.
Oh, no. She's just keeping out of me way because she knows I'm going to win those fags.
I wouldn't count on it. She can be as stubborn as a mule when she wants to be, that one. Yeah. Speaking of her ladyship, here she is.
Be you ought to see. Jacko and Lily.
Hey, Lizzie, I've got you some porridge.
Oh, not now. Miss Stomach wouldn't take
well,
it anyway.
Calm down. What's this about Jacko
and that
Lily?
Murderous, rotten bitch.
Quiet. If you want the screws in about it, we'll send a memo. What's Mackenzie done now?
She's half killed Jacko and Lil. God, you should have seen them. Beat the living daylights out of them.
Jacko and Lil, both of them together.
Well, how are they now?
Oh, RS, that's why I'm so late. Somebody had to try and help them.
Oh, God, B, what are we going to do? Because I'm next on the list.
Let's shut up and try to think. Do the screws know about it?
No way. Jacko wouldn't even go to the hospital, and you should see her hand be. It's terrible.
Babe, we've got to do something. She'll do a lot of us in.
Yeah, hell she will. I don't want to ask, so I'm in the top, right?
Are you going to see her on your own?
Oh, God, take care, B. She's built like a brick dummy.
Excuse me, Miss O'Shea,
I've finished. We can't let her do it on her own. We've got to go with her.
No, you won't. You just do as you're told. That's the trouble with this joint. In the old days, everybody did as they were told. Now this place is like a flaming madhouse.
What's this? A royal visit.
I think it's about time you and I had a little talk.
What's your problem?
I hear on the grapevine that Jacko and Lil had an accident.
Bad information, Smith. They ran into me, and that was no accident.
And Faye Quinn?
The same thing. But that was fun. Just a little workout to get a good night's sleep. Beats counting sheep.
Don't smart mouth me, Mackenzie. I think it's about time I taught you a little lesson.
Good. But you've messed up me schedule. Daniels was next. I was saving you for the grand final, just so you'd remember what happens when you send your girls after me.
I sent no one. You have been mine ever since you killed Patty. All mine.
Just visiting, are we, Smith?
Something like that.
Well, why don't you go and do it somewhere else? Now. You're supposed to be scrubbing the corridors.
Oh, where is she? Wish I kept me big mouth shut.
I wish you'd stop worrying, Lizzie. I mean, you're the one that's always telling me the bee can look after herself.
Well, so she can.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it. Not against Nola, anyway. Oh, but you're making her out to be some sort of superwoman or something.
Well, if you'd seen Lil and Jacko, God, they both looked as though they'd taken on a whole footy team.
Yeah, that's how I felt. I reckon she enjoys it.
Oh, but struth, she's only human.
Ha! Huh, says who? I mean, she's killed a cop, a husband, Paddy. She's done over a bank, broken out of the toughest slammer in WA. Then she bashes Lil and...
Oh, right, all right, all right, I believe you.
What hope do I have? May as well go out and throw myself under a tree.
Oh, I can't stand anymore. I'm going to see what's going on.
Everything all right, ladies? Where's Bea?
Oh, she went to the toot, Mrs. Morris. She reckoned the porridge upset her tummy.
Right.
Mrs. M, is it all right if I have my weekly phone call now?
Well, can't it wait till later?
Oh, yeah, but some of the girls are having their calls today and I just want to get in early.
All right, come on. Sorry to bother you, Heather, but could you get us a number, please? What is it?
I can never remember it. Can you read that?
Miss Morris.
I think the Auntie Mackenzie moves on again.
Well, what's happened?
I just caught her and Smith in a cell. Nothing had happened, but I'm sure that's only because they didn't want me as an audience.
Well, doesn't that prove my point? We'll have another murder on our hands this week and isolate her.
We can't. I've already told you what
I know that. But unless we can keep her under constant guard, what can we do?
Well, we're just going to have to keep her away from the other women. Now, look, I've got her on cleaning duties now, but, oh, she can go into the garden after lunch.
Yeah, well, that should help in working hours anyway. Listen, I've got to finish my rounds. Will you keep an eye on Quinn?
Yeah, well, when are you coming in to see me?
Come off it, Jimmy. You haven't been in to see me for ages.
Yeah, well, it's a pain for me too, you know. I can't just walk out and visit you whenever I like, can I? Like hell you will. You owe me, or have you forgotten? Yeah, that's better. Well, hang on a minute. Excuse me, Mrs. Powell, is it all right if I have a visitor tomorrow?
All right.
Yeah, it's great, so I'll see you then. Okay. Don't forget to bring me a present.
Wipe the smile off your face, Quinn. Still got a full morning's work to do.
Well, I'll have that girl. Mackenzie? You've turned into a very nasty person. You've upset me. And I don't upset easily.
I'm sorry, Miss Ferguson. Believe me, if I let anything slip about you, it was entirely intentional.
Oh, I'm sure it was. Unfortunately, there are some people in this place who think you should be believed.
Makes you laugh, doesn't it? I mean, I told you I didn't mention any names. I wonder what made them decide it was you that bashed me. Have you been a naughty girl?
I will be, Mackenzie. I promise you. Now, you killed a cop, and they want to hang you. I think that's right. So I'm going to make it my special project to send you back to WA, or save the government some money.
Meaning?
Well, all they want is for you to be dead. I don't think they'd mind if it happened in here.
Others have tried.
Others aren't me. Now get to lunch.
Her face isn't always going to be able to turn up at the right time in the wrong place.
Well, Bea, I can look after myself. But she's off her rocker. Have you seen Jacko's hand?
No.
Jacko? Jacko, show him your hand.
Oh, strike a light, love. It's getting worse. You gotta go and have it seen too.
No way. I'd have to answer too many questions.
Oh, don't be stupid. All I have to say is you've got it caught in the door. Get down to see the nurse as soon as possible. Is anything broken?
Don't think so. I can still move it.
What about you?
Oh, I've got a rotten headache and my stomach's not a pretty colour. No, she's black and blue.
B, we're going to have to do something before Nola kills someone else.
No way. You mucked it up last time because you wouldn't do what you were told. It's not going to happen again, especially not now.
How do you mean?
The screws are sticking to her like glue. You won't be able to get anywhere near her. I told you what happened this morning with Pal.
So what are we supposed to do now?
We are not going to do anything. I will look after her when the time is right. And if you go sticking your nose in again, you'll have me to answer to. Do you understand?
Yeah. All right.
Okay, girls, we've got a lot of catching up to do, so let's get at it.
Hang on, I just gotta find me fags first.
You don't have any left, remember?
Oh, bum. Hey, couldn't bot one from you, could I? I'll give it to you back when I win me bet for Maxie.
And supposing you don't win? Listen, seeing as you're giving up swearing, why don't you go the whole hog and give up smoking as well?
God, what do you think I am? That's why I've run out. I've smoked twice as much since I gave up swearing. Gotta let me have some pleasures left in life.
Okay, come here. Just one. Leaves me three until tomorrow's buy-up.
Oh, thank you, love.
Hey, Lizzie, want me to do your pick-up while you have your fag?
Yeah, thanks very much.
Hey. How come you're so keen to go out on your own all of a sudden? What about Nola? She don't scare me much. Anyway, I heard Officer Ward tell her that she had to go into the garden after lunch, so I'm safe. Besides, I want to call into the workshop.
What are you going to do with that?
What do you think? If your loony cellmate has a go at me, I want protection, but I've got to sharpen it first.
You need more than a knife if she gets the uncle.
Excuse me, but are you two on strike or something?
All right, don't get your wig wet. I'm going.
Maxie?
Oh, Mrs. M, go easy. Just about scared me into next week.
Yeah, what's the matter? Because you've seen a ghost.
Yeah, well, I thought all my birthdays had come at once. Whistle us something next time, will you?
As white as a sheet. Are you all right?
Yeah, just wasn't expecting anyone, that's all.
Come along, Maxine. Something's wrong. What is it?
No, you're imagining things, Mrs. M.
Am I? What about the bruising on Faye Quinn's face?
Yeah, well, she said she had a nightmare.
Now, you don't believe that any more than I do. What about Lil and Jacko?
What about them?
Running around like a couple of scared rabbits.
Are they? Gee, I wonder what's going on.
Yes, I wonder too. Off you go.
Yeah, righto. See you, Mrs. Hemp.
What the hell am I supposed to do out here?
Well, you can start by pulling out the weeds.
I wouldn't know weed from a gum tree.
Oh, that's easy. If you get a hernia, you've pulled out a gum tree.
Oh, terrific. Look, why can't I do something inside? I hate gardening.
If you used your brains, you'd realize this is for your own good. Besides, I would have thought you'd appreciate getting away from the other women for a while. You're not exactly popular with them.
Who told you that? Okay. So we got away to a bumpy start. But I'm never going to get to know them stuck out here, am I?
Oh, come off it, Mackenzie. This isn't a fun farm. Now, you will do as you're damn well told.
Yeah.
If she gives you any trouble, just call the gate guard.
And who am I going to call if she starts giving me trouble?
Try me. Hope your lungs are good, though. Don't know where I'll be.
Just asked a question, that's all.
Yes, well, now you know. Do as you're told and get on with it.
Ah, come on, for God's sake, I got a headache. Knock it off!
How does she do that? Oh, don't be such a goose. The knock-off bell takes 40 seconds. She just counts.
As it happens, I didn't.
This time.
Well, how about doing something really clever and getting us some fags for tonight like you used to do in the olden days?
That was before the fire. People had things stashed around. Anyway, stop grizzling and I won't give you a drag of the one I got left.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you got back quick. I thought you was in the garden.
I was. Did you make your contact?
Oh, yes, coming in tomorrow.
No trouble?
No, I just took my weekly phone call and told him to get in here.
Right. Then we're all set.
Yeah, but for what? I don't even know what's going on.
Trust me, that's all you've got to know. You're not becoming unfriendly again.
No, of course not.
Good. Because you and me are going to become partners in a little business venture. Stick with it and you'll have quite a bundle by the time you get out of here.
Sounds all right to me.
Thought it would.
Oh, I think there's something you ought to know.
Like what?
Well, Maxie's got a knife. She reckons she'll use it on you if you give her a hard time. I just thought you ought to know. Nola?
Oh, come over. Do you have to hit the flaming thing over here?
Well, it's not my fault. She keeps bashing it all over the place, you
well,
silly little
Lizzie,
idiot.
You have to hit it over the net.
Yeah, I know that, but you're hitting it too hard.
You ready?
Oh, there you are. You've done it again.
But that's the idea. That's how you win.
For crying out loud, will you let her hit the ball?
Yeah, don't forget, love. I'm an old woman.
Yeah, all right, Lizzie, but later on, I've got to go to the toot. Hey, Angie, want to take me place? B.
What?
Tina, what are you doing? I led you that opposite on purpose. We've been playing hearts.
B, will you come to the loo with
me? Never mind, I'm trying to concentrate.
Yeah, but B, if you don't come, Nola might be there.
Oh, all right. Look, go with Faye. Hey, Faye, hold Tinkerbell's hand while she goes to the loo, will you?
Who? Thanks heaps.
Whose lead is it?
Mine.
Well, isn't that just terrific? I thought top dogs were supposed to look after us.
Well, she sent me with you, didn't she?
Yeah. You couldn't hit water if you fell out of a boat.
Thanks very much.
Oh. Must be my lucky day. I've been looking for you, Daniels.
You leave me alone.
Get lost, Quinn. But now! And now you are going to get hurt. And for that, you're going to get very badly hurt.
Ah!
picnic today. Now that was stupid. Real stupid.
You rotten mongrel. What do you want to go and do that to little Maxie for? She never did you any harm.
But she tried. And nobody does that to me.
Well, I won't try, Mackenzie. When I finish with you, you'll be begging to be sent back to Western Australia.
So you keep saying. Look, what have I got to do to get you going, Queenie? I killed one of your mates, bashed four of the others. What's stopping you now?
Screws.
You need a charmed life, don't you? But don't worry. It will happen.
Everything all right, ladies?
Oh, fine, Mrs. Powell. Just asking Nola what Western Australia was like. She says it's a lovely place, but she wouldn't want to live there.
As you probably know, Daniels has been badly beaten. I want to know who was responsible. I was hoping that for once you would forget your ridiculous no-lagging code and use some common sense.
We wouldn't do anything to hurt little Maxie, Mrs. Davidson. She's one of our mates.
Obviously, someone doesn't think so.
Well, how bad is she? I mean, is she going to be all right?
The sister seems to think so. She's keeping her in for observation for tonight. Now, for the last time, if someone is prepared to tell me who is responsible, they can do so in the privacy of my office.
If we hear anything, we'll let you know, Mrs. Davidson.
Very well. But until I get some cooperation in this matter, the ban on buyer privileges remains.
Figs, what are we going to do now? Be I'm going nutty for a fag.
Nothing either of us can do at the moment.
Hi there. They tell me a gal can get a decent cup of coffee here. What are my chances?
Well, kid, I'll tell you one thing. The only thing decent you'll get around here has been brought in from out of town.
I must have said something wrong. We'll try it again. Hi there. They tell me...
quit clowning around.
Ah, well, somebody's got to. Can't have you walking around with a face like a well-smacked bum. You'll scare everyone away.
I'm sorry, Helen. It's just I'm getting sick of this neighborhood. I mean, if the kids aren't writing filth all over the front of the building, then...
Oh, yes, I saw it. Lovely thought. But they spelt it all wrong.
Yeah, well, when they get tired of doing that, they then use the windows as target practice.
Oh, God, that is bad. You know, it's broken on both sides.
You're a nut, you know that.
Okay, Jude, what's the matter? You certainly do not look like a gal who just copped herself $100,000. Tell you the truth, I came over here to help you celebrate.
Celebrate? You're looking at someone who lost her family twice in one lifetime. One thing is for certain, Helen. Money cannot buy happiness.
So be miserable in luxury. Come on, Jude, forget about the family. They do not exist. You hate this neighborhood, so all right already. Go get yourself a ritzy uptown address. God knows you can afford it. I mean, you'd have a look at this dump. Now, no offense meant. You've done a terrific job with it. It used to be a dirty, run-down dump, and now it is a clean, livable dump. But a dump is still a dump. And most of the women spit in your eye every time you want to help them. What you need is to get away from this whole scene. And just think, Jude. You get yourself a ritzy uptown address, at least you'll be able to read the graffiti. The kids up there spell real well. Why do I get the feeling I'm talking to myself, Jude?
Uptowner?
Mm-hmm.
Ritzy new address, hey?
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what?
I'm all ears.
Driscoll House is gonna change its address.
But I had to tell
them. Why, quick?
Well, because...
Not quick enough, why?
Well, because I was with Maxie and Maxie would have told me. And, oh, geez, Nola, you told me to stay friends with them all.
Good girl.
Hey?
So long as you had a good reason for it. Now, sit down. We're going to talk about your visitor. You can get money from him, right?
Yeah, but what for?
We are going into the retail business. Mackenzie and Quinn. We're going to make a packet.
Yeah? How?
Well, for starters, so far as the other women are concerned, I've got nothing to do with it. They like you, but they don't like me. So it makes sense they'd buy from you.
Yeah, but what are they buying? We got nothing to sell.
We will have. You're going to tell Sorry. Ask your visitor friend to get some tobacco into us.
Tobacco? How's he gonna do that?
You'll find a way. I've got every faith in you. Just remember, no buy-up. They'll be going crazy for cigarettes. You'll find a way.
Birdsworth, Young, Daniels, Smith, Laundry, Mackenzie, Garden, Adler, Murray and Quinn, Workshop. Okay, oh, come on, keep the noise down. Be at your work areas in 5 minutes.
Excuse me, Mrs. Powell.
What?
Can I go in the garden too?
Well, I'd like to know why, especially with Mackenzie out there.
Oh, that is why, sort of. I mean, because I share a cell with her, the other girls don't trust me, and they're giving me heaps, even at meal times. I'm getting sick of it.
Yes, all right. Come on, I'll change the roster.
Surprised at you, Smith. Thought Lawson was a friend of yours.
Meaning?
Mind you, I'm not complaining. I always said that this place would be a lot more peaceful when someone got the better of you. Looks like Mackenzie's done just that. Still, I would have thought you'd have done something about her by now.
Well, don't cancel your bets, because the race is still on.
So while Helen was trying to talk me into moving to a better area, I got this idea. Why not move Driscoll House as well?
Well, I can appreciate you wanting to upgrade the house, but the expense, I don't think Mr. Douglas...
What expense? I'm rich now, remember?
Well, what are you suggesting?
Look, if I buy a house and then I lease it to the PRG, the PRG can hit the department for the same amount of money they've been paying. That'll cover rates and expenses. Of course, Helen thought I was going out of my brain. She said, why don't you go and live a life of luxury somewhere?
It would be easier.
Nah, I gotta keep busy. Which reminds me, have you heard anything about the careers officer's job?
Well, unofficially you've been accepted, but you know the department. We'll have to wait for written confirmation. I'll call Mr. Douglas, tell him your idea about Driscoll House, and remind him of your appointment. Excuse me. Thank you. She'll be there in a moment. Smith's waiting for you in the garden.
Right. Well, thanks, Mrs. Davidson, and good luck with the department.
Judy, there's something I'd like you to do for me.
Sure, what is it?
We have trouble on our hands. Serious trouble.
Mackenzie?
I won't ask you how, you know. Just talk to Bea and tell her not to be silly.
Well, don't worry, Mrs. Davidson. That's why I'm here.
Good. I have to come to reception, so I'll come along with you.
Are you listening to me, Faye?
What? Oh, I'm sorry. It's so hard to concentrate with Bea watching us. What'd you say?
The fence. You know how it's double all the way round?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, just over there by the road, they look about... Don't stare. They look about 30 feet apart. Just perfect for someone to toss something over.
Oh, yeah.
Don't stare.
Sorry. We've had stuff tossed over there before.
Right. Well, just... make sure your friend knows where to go.
All right.
Don't do it, Bea. It's not worth it.
Isn't it? You know what I've been through, Jude. Every time anyone mentions Patty's name, she laughs. Bitch just laughs.
Well, let her laugh. I mean, she's copped a lifetime in the slammer. Isn't that enough?
I'm gonna kill her, Jude. I have to.
And what's that gonna prove? Okay, Patty was a nice kid, but do you think she would have wanted you to cop an additional 10 years for something that's not going to change a damn thing?
Oh, yes, it will. Get rid of her for a start.
It won't change a damn thing. You're talking to me, remember? I'm the one that busted a gut trying to kill Jock Stewart. Well, thank God I didn't, because I'm out now, Bea. Out's beautiful. There are lots of Nola Mackenzies in the world. What about Vera and the freak? You're going to kill them all?
What'd she expect me to do? She looked like she was going to eat the two of us. Should have seen the look she gave me in the garden when Po-Face changed her mind and put me in there with her.
Yeah. All right, all right.
Anyhow, you don't look too bad.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I'll just go back and ask her to do it again.
Excuse me, Nola. Would you mind making me face the same colour as me ribs?
Of course I'll look all right. She's a pro. She don't leave no marks.
She did on me. And what about Jacko?
Yeah, well, I knew it's an improvement.
Oh, thanks very much.
Come on, Dean.
Jude understands. Of course she ought to. She's been through enough.
Well, she's not going through it now. She's outside, she's free, and she's loaded with dough, so why doesn't she just keep her ideas to herself?
Because she loves you. Like we all do. She wouldn't have come in if she didn't, now would she? Besides, I reckon she's right.
Hattie's dead.
So what are you gonna do? Bring her back to life? You're only Queen Bee, you're not God Almighty. You kill Mackenzie, and it's over for her. But you, you'll be in here forever. So it doesn't make sense, does it? Nobody wins.
Lizzie, just go away. It's my decision. Just go away.
Come on, you lot. Clean up and move out. Not you, Quinn. You got a visitor.
I couldn't get in before. The boss won't give me time off during the week, and I pencil for Ronnie every Saturday.
Oh, bugger Ronnie. He's a big, rich bookie. Let him get someone else to pencil for him. Hell, you don't need the money. I've given you enough in the past, remember?
Yeah, okay, love. You don't have to keep reminding me.
Well, it's all right for you, isn't it? I mean, you don't have to be stuck in this rotten joint all day. You know what? They cancelled our buy-up this week. I'm not kidding. I'd kill for a fag.
Give it up.
Yeah, that's what the school kids said.
School kids?
Yeah, rotten little mongrels. They stand outside the fence puffing their heads off all day. And when we ask them to toss some over, they reckon they can't. And that's rubbish. There's one place near the road where the two fences are real close together. Anyone could do it.
Yeah? Anyone, eh?
Yeah. I wouldn't mind betting they'll be back again there this arvo.
Well, that's great. You mean he's approved the whole deal?
With reservations. He thinks you're a little optimistic about getting a larger place for that amount of money.
No worries. Look, I've been checking the papers. There's dozens of places that look just perfect.
Yes, but if you had to take out a mortgage, you could be pretty well living from hand to mouth.
Well, I'll cross that bridge when I come to it, you know?
Okay, girls, this is
a rave. Mrs. Davidson, I better go now. I'll talk to you later, okay? Right. Thanks. Bye. Oh, you got a big mouth, you know that?
No. Careful how you speak to the poor people. What did Davo want?
Oh, nothing. Just rang to tell me that the department has approved me buying a new house.
Well, that's decent of them, seeing as though it's your money.
Oh, cut it out. Come on, have a look at this. I've been circling all the places that look great. Now, you check it out. I'll put the kettle on. Best one's there, bottom left.
This is the best? You gotta be kidding me.
What?
For people with imagination, renovator's dream, that means it's a dump.
Well, so it needs a bit of work. Who cares?
Oh, Judy, if I can't talk you out of this, can I at least introduce you to a client of mine? He's got his own real estate firm. What do you say?
Sure. Now, what do you want, coffee or tea?
Jimmy's there.
Oh, well, listen, don't panic. Just go and tell the screws you want a shovel or something.
Yeah, okay. What you gonna do?
Oh, get going.
Sorry, miss, but I really need the big shovel.
Yes. Governor, they're hardly good reading for our lot, though. Exciting escape stories, happy on. It's a wonder they didn't send the handyman's guide to bomb making as well.
I don't think you'll have any need to worry. When you've gone through them, get a couple of women to take them to the library.
Yeah.
Oh, Miss Ferguson, I have to fix that. You take a tea break.
No, I'll pack these up first.
Mackenzie and Quinn, they're working in the garden. It wouldn't hurt them to come in early and take care of this.
All right, but keep Mackenzie away from the other women. I think we'll still have trouble there.
Ruth, hurry up. Here comes Po-Face and the Governor.
Come over here quickly. You can take the rest of it.
What do I do with it?
Put it in your sock. Quickly.
Shit.
Quinn.
Come on, you two. I want you to do a job for me in the library.
The library? Oh, God, I hate books.
Really? I heard a rumour you used to run one. Come on, get in.
You're a good boy, Harry. I give you a few extras next time you're around. Okay, so on the house if you like. On the bed, it'd be more comfortable. Okay, I'll see you in an hour. Now, you better make that two. All right.
Well, that, Judy, me love, is how you buy real estate.
What do you say?
He has the perfect house and he'll show it to you if you can drag yourself away from here.
That's fantastic. Hey, how much?
You leave that for me to bargain with alone, if you catch my drift.
You know something? You're a fast worker. Why didn't you come and help me run the house?
Oh, Jude, don't start that again.
Well, why not? I mean, we get along great, don't we?
That has nothing to do with it. For a start, what would the pay be? 1.5? 200?
You gotta be kidding.
Well, I earn that in an hour. Besides, I could not hack all the hassles you have with these girls.
Well, trying to get off the game, aren't you?
Sure I do, but I want to go to something easier, and this is not exactly the life of Riley. Now, come on, Jude, please get off my back. I'll help you all that you want me to, but it is strictly unofficial, okay?
Okay. Till next time.
Of course I can't give up smoking. It's not natural.
Well, will you take up swearing again, because you're driving me up the flaming wall?
Well, if I could get those 10 fags from you, I'd be apples. God, this reminds me of the war. Couldn't get any smoke, so we used to get tea leaves and brown paper.
Ladies.
Just taking a smoke, eh, Miss Ferguson?
Yeah, without the smoke.
Well, you better get back to work then.
Why should we? We're ahead of schedule, so why bust a gut? If you'll pardon the expression.
I don't, Smith. And that expression has just earned you an insubordination charge.
Are you serious?
Oh, you'll find out. Besides, you need a change of scenery. Come on.
Was a put-up job. Wonder what the freak's up to.
I don't know, but she had that look on her face. I reckon B's in real trouble.
I don't suppose you're going to tell me what this is all about.
Extra duties for insubordination. The PRG have given us a couple of cartons of books. You can unpack them.
Working in the library? Mm-hmm. It's a pretty cushy job for punishment, isn't it?
You know me, Smith. An old softy. Go on, move.
Oh, g'day, B.
Well, well, well. So this is it. Finally got the nerve, eh? Get lost.
B?
Get out.
Right. Hey, Miss Ferguson. Oh, I got
then go, Quinn.
Yeah, but...
Move it.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.